Representatives from over 50 small and medium enterprises, SMEs, participated in the training, which aimed at familiarizing them with the opportunities available under the African Continental Free Trade Agreement, signed in 2018. This historic agreement has created a single African market with over 1.3 billion consumers, presenting immense prospects for business across the continent. Brown Twebaze, a consultant trainer attached to UNDP, emphasized the importance of aligning SMEs with the existing marketing needs in order to attract clientele at the continental level.
Like in Kenya now, our market share from Ugandan products is 11.2%. In the DRC, it is 8.16%, which shows that we already have great potential to trade on any proximity trading block. You see? And then the other opportunity is we have got available redundant labor. Labor to do market research, labor to help us access new technologies. Labor help us mobilize capital for us, do, you know, fulfill due diligence lending institutional requirements. So we have got university graduates who can well tap into this.
He highlighted the significant potential for growth and success if SMEs can effectively tap into the expanded market.
For instance, value addition initiatives. Every product tradable on this trading block must be associated with appropriate value chain system, so that now the targeted consumer anywhere in a member country is capable of getting attracted and interested in the product. Okay, and so then the other strategies to employ is to understanding the suitable technologies like online training methods, so that they know how well they can adopt the skill of trading using online applications.
Erasmus Natumanya, the commercial officer of Kabale District, emphasized the necessity for local producers to prioritize quality and standard output to meet regional and continental demands effectively.
You know, when you look at the modules, it is preparing them to compete worldwide, not within the country, but it's intra-trade in Africa. Yeah, so that you can get your products here. They are taking them through, they are preparing them what they need from the legal, from the tax regimes, how they should register their business, the branding, the marketing, all those modules are there. So Brown, the consultant, is taking them through on how to prepare to compete.
Participants who benefited from the training expressed their gratitude, stating that it provided them with valuable insights into the numerous opportunities available to them.
The level where we are, we have some challenges, especially lacking the standards, the UNBS standard that would help us to cross the borders and take our products there. And the process of acquiring this mark, the quality mark, is very rigorous. I've actually sent my samples twice to UNBS, and usually they send them back that we have not qualified. So we'd like to request UNDP and other bodies to help us, the women especially.
Given such trainings, we are going to run away from the rudimentary way of doing things and mechanizing our businesses, and so we shall be able to compete internationally.
It is projected that the African Continental Free Trade Area Agreement will lift an estimated 30 million people out of poverty in Africa, with an additional 68 million individuals escaping moderate poverty. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.